What's up, family? Man, I want to jump on and have a heart to heart with you guys today. Man, I got a tattoo years ago, decades ago, of a tribal of a lotus flower right here. Part of my phoenix coming up underneath it. I don't know if you guys can see this clearly, but I got this years ago. And I had just finished doing this real deep study on the lotus flower. Stay with me, we're going to go somewhere. And the lotus flower is a trip because it grows in dirty, murky water. You know what I mean? Just swampy, nasty, grimy, dark water, right? And as it grows up, man, it pushes past all of the dirt, all of the filth, and comes to the surface and blossoms into this beautiful flower. As chosen ones, that's what we do. Chosen ones, we are lotus flowers. Stay with them, we're going somewhere. And it's a trip because so often, you know, in my past, I struggled with wanting to, how can I say this, make my mom proud of me. You know, again, my mom passed away when I was 2 years old, you know, and that desire to make my mama proud of me is what got me started on this journey. You know what I mean? This journey of wanting to be a beacon of hope, a beacon of love and compassion. This journey of wanting to help other people. It was the death of my mom that got me started on this path. Stay with me. I'm going somewhere. The question is, what got you started? What got you on the journey you're on? What was it in life that got you moving the direction you're going? What got you caught up into the dope game? What got you caught up into just giving your body away and not respecting and cherishing your body as a king or as a queen? What was it that got you drinking alcohol the way you do? What was it that got you popping pills the way you do? What was it that got you lying and trying to seek validation the way you do? See, our journey in life, man, it started from something. You know what I mean? What was it that threw you on this or put you on this path? You know, what pain, what trauma did you go through? See, we talk a lot about diving deep in shadow work, you know, and diving deep into the subconscious mind, you know, and understanding who I am. You can't understand who the fuck you is until you dive deep. You can't understand who the fuck you are until you go to the deep wounds of your past. And understand, what was it that made you the way that you are? What was it that got you caught up the way you did? See, that desire to please my mama at an early age made me want to be a beacon. I didn't understand it. And so what I did at the time was I was attracted to broken women. Been attracted to broken because I saw my mama damaged. I saw my mama screaming and crying and bleeding. And I wanted to save my mama, but as a two-year-old, I couldn't. There's nothing I could do as a two-year-old kid. But what that did was it put me on the path of, okay, man, now I got to help women. I got to help broken women. I got to help damaged women. I got to help women that are fucked up. Stay with me. We're going somewhere. And that wasn't the journey that I was supposed to get on. That wasn't the path that I was supposed to get on. But because I saw the pain and the trauma from my mama, I thought that's where I was supposed to go. To help broken women like my mama. Help damaged women like my mama. I missed it. I missed it. And all I did was cause myself more pain, more trauma, more suffering, more heartache, more broken hearts. Because I misunderstood my journey. I misunderstood my mission. I misunderstood my purpose. My purpose was to be a beacon of hope and love, a beacon of light. That was my purpose. My purpose was never to go out into the world to fix damaged women. My purpose was never to go out into the world to show women that, man, I'm not like those other guys. I'm different. That was never my purpose. I thought it was my purpose. And because I thought it was my purpose, I willingly jumped on that path. And all I did was hurt myself more in the process. I did. And then I got frustrated because the relationships didn't work. The relationships was never going to work because I was attracted to damaged women. I was attracted to broken women. Why? Because I was still damaged. I was still hurt. And I was misunderstanding my purpose. It's crazy how that all ties in. And you don't see that until you start diving deep. You don't see that until you push past your fears and your insecurities. You don't see that until you push past your ego and your victim mentality. Your woe is me, and these bitches ain't shitting. Okay, why did I choose them? They didn't make me get in a relationship with them. I willingly got in a relationship with them. Why? Because I was fucked up. Because I misunderstood my purpose. It wasn't their fault. That was my fault. And so when the shit didn't work, I blamed them. When the truth is, it was my fault. It was all my fault. Because I chose them. We came here to be beacons of hope and love. We came here to be a beautiful lotus flower. We have to learn to push past our trauma. We have to learn to understand our trauma and to grow through it. You guys hear me say all the time, man, don't just go through it, grow through it. Don't just go through the crazy shit in life. We have to grow through it. And that's exactly what the Lotus does. It grows through its darkest points. It grows through the depths of the water. It grows through the mud and the murk. It grows through it. And then it presents itself, this beautiful flower, for all the world to see. This is what we do as chosen ones. This is what we do as star seeds, as rainbow warriors, as light workers, as healers. We grow through all of our pain and trauma and suffering. And we present ourselves to the world as this beacon of love, this beacon of hope. It don't matter where you start out in life. It don't matter what you've gone through. You can still be a beautiful lotus flower because that's what you are. Don't get caught up in the craziness and the chaos of where you're at or what things look like. Don't get caught up in your circumstances. Grow through them. I hope and pray that I said something to encourage you, to inspire you, to even challenge your way of thinking. We have to grow up. We have to grow up. We have to understand who we are. And the great majority of us, we've missed that. We don't understand. We have no clue who we are and why we're here. Because the truth is, we've gotten distracted and we're not willing to do the work. The deep work, the hard work, the dirty work, the grimy work. We'll do the dirty, grimy work to get money. We'll do the dirty, grimy work to get ahead in life, but we won't do the dirty, grimy work to understand who we are and why we're here. Man, I love you guys. Happy healing. Peace.